far-right parties start out in just about everywhere beyond the pale, at the extremes. And that was the case in Austria. And I'm wondering if Hofer put forward the kinder, gentler face of the far-right and has brought it closer to acceptability and closer to someday really taking power.
Well, I think he certainly tried to do that. I mean, when I spoke to him immediately after the election results, I asked him about the fact, I asked him whether he was a populist. And he said, no, I'm not a populist. I'm just a regular guy. And he said, I am right, but I'm not an extremist. On the other hand, the Freedom Party, the FPÖ, is an old party here. It was founded by former SS members, and it does have those Nazi roots. Now, now Hofer has gone out of his way to try and distance himself, but there are many concerned that he hasn't really abandoned some of those far-right principles. So we'll have to see what happens in the days to come. Hofer had told me that he would actually take it easy and read The Old Man and the Sea for a while and just relax. But I think his party is still very much going to mobilize, and they will have parliamentary elections soon, not in the next year or so, but it is something that they are gearing up for and hoping to take a few more seats in.